Hello, Herman here with a new video in the ClearPass workshop series where we will deploy ClearPass from scratch and integrate with wired, wireless, Active Directory and much more. This is the 2021 edition, and in this video we will be deploying our ClearPass virtual machine into an ESXi server. In the last video I left you at the Aruba support portal. This is where we can download the ESXi image, so I did download it in the meantime. And I got a big zip file, which I extracted on the deployment machine. And let's have a look how that will work. So here is my ESXi. What we can do here is we can create, register a new VM. We want to deploy it from an OVF or OVA file. So we click next here. We need to give it a name, cppm1pub. So it will be the publisher for cppm. And here we need to select the files that we downloaded. So you need to add the OVF and the VMDK, but you can just throw all of them in and it will just take these. So this is the definition and this is the disk image, and we can add that. So here we need to decide where we want to store the data. I'll take the data store because I have plenty of space on there. Then here we have the end user agreement. So we need to carefully read this all, and then at the end we need to agree with it. Press next. Here is where we have the network mapping. So there are two interfaces, the data interface, the management interface. So management interface is first one. We'll put them in VLAN 10 both. I recommend not to use the data interface, just use the management interface. Then also here we have the disk provisioning, where I would recommend to put the disk provisioning on thick. That will allocate all the disk space on the hypervisor ESXi. That will prevent that when a disk space is growing, that at some point your hypervisor will run out of space and all your VMs will come to a stall. So here we have a summary, and here we can press finish. Oh, I need to go back. I don't want to power on the VM because we need to do more. I'll show you later on. So let's finish it, and the deployment is running at this point. So let's get back to the support portal, because I mentioned we need to add a disk, and what we need to add and where we need to add it is here in the installation guide. So let's have a look here in the installation guide. So where we need to go here is to the system requirements. So it's recommended to go through the complete guide here, but I'll do the most important points here. We have the virtual appliance requirements. Then here we have the requirements for the ESXi. And as you can see, there are multiple sizes, and depending on the amount of resources that you allocate, you can deploy one of these appliances. So for the LabV, this is the lab environment that we will deploy in. We need to add 160 gigabyte disk space. If we want to have the production versions of the appliances, you can do the C1000V, which will do 500 concurrent users, the C2000, which can do 5000 concurrent users, and we have a C3000, the big one, with 25,000 concurrent users. You can see the amount of CPUs you need to add, the amount of memory, and as well the amount of disk space. So yeah, we need to add an additional disk of 160 gigabytes of disk space. Let's go back to my deployment process. We can see that it completed in the meantime. So we can edit the VM. And here on the VM, we will add a hard disk. Add a new standard hard disk. As mentioned, the size will be 160 gigabytes for the lab VM environment. And we press save here to get this deployed. Now it's time to power it on. And we can see the VM is starting. Let's have a look here at the console. You can see it's booting up the first time. And once it's booted up, you can see that we need to select here the size of the appliance. And as mentioned, we are using the LabV appliance. So we press one and enter. If you have one of the production sizes and you assigned the right CPU, so you can see I did assign too many CPUs here and too much RAM memory. But it won't hurt. So I'll leave it like that for now. If it's at least the minimum requirement, it should be good. We press 1 here, and it will now warn that it will wipe the data on the 160 GB disk. So yes, we do allow that, and we don't do the disk encryption. So this is a lab environment. In production, it's recommended to do the disk encryption as well, but it will put a slight overload on the CPU for the encryption and the decryption. So at this point, we see that the initialization is going on. It's copying the file system contents to the new assigned disk. And yeah, this will take a few minutes. So I'll let it run and be back. You can see the initial boot. It finished now, and we have a login prompt at this point. This, by the way, took roughly 3 or 4 minutes to complete this first boot. What we now should do is we should log in, and we should log in with the username appadmin, and the password should be etips123. And then the TIPS will be capital letters. So now it's asking for the hostname, so let's put the hostname in here as well, cppm1-pub. Here we need to put an IP address for the management port. So that's, in my case, in VLAN 10.1.10.11 for the publisher /24. And the gateway will be 10.1.10.1. That will be my default gateway. I don't deploy IPv6 at this point, so I just press enter. I don't use the data port at this point because it's not recommended. So I press enter here as well. Same for the IPv6 here. I can add my primary DNS server, which is secondary 10. So I don't want to use Slack mode, which is for IPv6. I need to put a new password here. So by the way, this password is also used for the initial login to the web interface. So put a nice password in here. Now it's asking if we want to set the date information. So let's do that. I prefer to have NTP. My NTP server is NTP. I don't need a secondary. I do want to create the time zone. So I'm in Europe, and then I'm in the Netherlands, 32, and that's okay. So let's acknowledge that. I don't want to enable FIPS mode. So if you don't know that you need to enable FIPS mode, you don't need to enable it. It's for governments and for financials mostly that have the requirement to have FIPS mode enabled. If you don't have the requirement, don't enable it. Then from this point we get an overview, and it looks all good from this point. So let's press here yes to continue, and now it will go into the second round of setup. So you can see the complete boot up completed now, and we can see the IP address has been assigned. So now let's have a look if we can access the web interface. /tips, that's the main interface. So we do see a certificate warning at this point. We'll fix that later on. So we need to bypass it. And we are now asked to add a license. So we'll continue adding the license and doing the initial configuration of the ClearPass in the next video. So by the way, we did install ClearPass at this point on ESXi. So you can see in the ClearPass doc page that there are also instructions here to how to deploy it on Amazon Web Services, AWS, or on Microsoft Azure. So you can run it in the cloud as well. As well here in the installation guide, you can see there are also guides for Microsoft Hyper-V or KVM. Other hypervisor platforms, or as well for Microsoft Azure or the AWS deployment of ClearPass Policy Manager. So you are free to deploy it where you want. So hope this was useful. Please press the like button if you do appreciate the video. Put your comments below the videos, and also remember to subscribe to the channel so you will be notified as soon as new videos come on.